Welcome to another episode of Alberta Backwoods Adventures. In this episode, we're heading back to the fort for a cold overnighter. My pathway through the bush is covered with snow now. Makes it a little hard to pack this bag through the forest. Having a hard time getting to the fort today. I have 56 pounds of gear on my back. I'm hiking through snow. It's a great time. There's a brown trout swimming down there. Pretty cool, eh? Here's a prime example of one of those game trails I talked about in an earlier video. You can see deer tracks here, all the way through the forest. It's a good way for tracking. It's good to know what's around too. You see bear prints in there, you might want to stay away. Well, that's my pack, all 56 pounds of it. How nice that that's off. You can see again, nobody's been at the lean-to. Nobody but Old Man Winter. Right on.
Now the first order of the day is to get some dry clothes on. And then set up camp. Let's get her going.
I'm gonna take a minute here and show you my bed. Kind of explain what's happening in layers. So I've got my military sleeping bag here. Then my military sleeping pad. Followed by another military sleeping pad. Followed by an insulated tarp folded in half. So that's gonna give me a nice cushion sleeping on these hard logs, and also it's gonna give me some nice warmth as well. So this is my wood stove. I made it out of an old bucket and some old stove pipe. Got a nice piece of tin behind it there to keep the logs from burning. And this stove works incredibly well for cooking and for warming up. Okay, so now we have our camp set up here. We got the bed set up there. The wood stove in the corner. She's looking good. Now let's get to work. So last time we were here, I put these three posts over the lean-to to make a roof out of it. Now I've got to revise this plan a little bit, move the one in the center over and add one more. That way give the roof a little more strength, and then I'll weave some debris in there and then we'll tarp her in. Okay, now we got our fourth one put on there. I'm gonna start working on some cross members going across there. That way it'll add more stability and also hold the tarp up better when it gets loaded down with snow. So these here are the bare essentials. If you're gonna be doing some bushcraft woodworking, you wanna have a bow saw, a hatchet, and a good knife at the bare minimum. I pack those in. And if you're lucky, you also get a hammer and a wedge. I brought those in too. So, it's 2 degrees outside right now. It's actually a nice fall day. About 70% humidity. It's supposed to snow later, so we'll keep an eye on the temperature. Okay guys, now that we got our lattice work done, we're gonna start coming around the side, framing that in. Start putting some vertical members up and down there, and then we'll wave some branches in between. Now we've done our sides there, the supports, we can start weaving branches in and start from the bottom, work your way to the top. Now, young saplings are the best. are freshly cut spruce boughs. They will work the best because they're flexible. If you're using old dry wood, it's just going to snap in half on you. Now that's completed. That'll keep the wind out, keep the snow out, and keep people out actually. It's really good camouflage as well. Okay guys, so here's the other side. We'll just have to figure out a solution for the door. Now we can start on the roof. Here's a good look from far away. You can see how well camouflaged it is. Let's get started on that roof. So I will start by rolling the tarp up, working my way down from the top, and making sure she's nice and taut, because you don't want the snow ripping through it. Here she is all tarped up. Now the next thing we're going to do is go inside and make an opening, like a flap for the smoke to escape. So now I've cut a hole in the roof there. What I'm going to do is go around the edge of the tarp where it's cut and apply some duct tape all around the edges so it doesn't fray. Here's a look inside. Provides a lot of daylight during the day. Little stove, wood pile, looking good. Now the last thing I've done to the smoke flap is tape a stick to it that's wider than the opening. So she folds down nice, stays down, like so. Okay, so all the work is done on the lean-to. Now it's time to chop firewood. Prepare for the evening. We're losing sunlight fast here. Now, something I always bring with me when I go backpacking are these guys here. You can always start a fire with these. If it's wet, it doesn't matter. They always work. So they're really good for starting fire. Something else I brought though, I packed in some dry birch bark too. That's really essential for starting fires because it burns like crazy. We'll see how. So there's our setup there. Two fuel tabs and some layers of birch bark and chopped up dry pine. And let's get this fire started and then we can cook some dinner. Tonight's dinner gonna be beans and rice cooked over the fire. Beans for the veggies and rice for the starch. Keep you nice and full. So it's 5:30 at night now and this is October 13th today and it's 4 degrees outside. So it's a pretty nice day here. You can see there's snow on the ground still, quite a lot, but it's melted and it's continuing to melt. But we're supposed to get to zero tonight, so we'll keep an eye on that temperature. Let's take a walk down to the watering hole. Here she is. Clear, clean mountain water. Loving Alberta. And now we're back at the lean-to. Got the start of an open fire and the wood stove that was cooking dinner. We'll let that die down and let this one take over. You can see how that smoke flap functions. It functions rather well. It's not very smoky inside the lean-to. And everything's going as planned. Just another look at how camouflaged this thing really is. You can see my crappy paint job on the tarp, but it seems to blend in well with the ground and the surroundings. It just looks like a snowy forest. Just another look at the smoke flap. You can see how everything's rising out the hole. There's no residual smoke inside. That works great.
We can see now it's -2 outside. Let's go check inside the lean-to. Well, it was -2 outside, and inside the lean-to with the small fire, we got a balmy +16. Real nice. Not even a big fire going. Now I'm over here in the corner, away from the fire, where it's most likely the coldest point, other than in the bed. And here we are, +16. Good morning. This is what we wake up to today. Very much winter again. But Mother Nature's done a great job of camouflaging the fort for us, so we don't have to worry about that. Now here we are back at home base, and you can see snow everywhere here too. Very much winter now. But I love it. We'll be right back.